This Seatrade Cruise Destination of the Year award is an achievement for which all Barbados and all Barbadians can feel really proud. We, of course, are happy to receive the award, but Barbados never proceeded on this path to achieve an award. It was about a humanitarian approach to dealing with other people who were in need. And it helps to remember that there were Barbadians on board ships all over the world at the time. In fact, I have a young constituent who was on board a ship at the time who tells me that he was very proud of Barbados, and other members on board the ship were very proud of Barbados for allowing other people to leave and for allowing him to come home when at the time other people were not doing so. In fact, he told me that the other crew members were very envious of the position that Barbados took. And what exactly is that position? At the peak of the pandemic, Barbados had about 13 vessels in our waters. That is between March 23rd and March 24th. The total calls made to Barbados during that time were 71. There were 23,002 passengers who arrived and 18,849 passengers who disembarked. The crew who came were 32,934. So you can see that indeed a lot of movement and a lot of work was occurring in the Bridgetown port. Currently we have 4 vessels in Barbados waters, all operated by Royal Caribbean International. There are Serenade of the Seas, Harmony of the Seas, Liberty of the Seas, and Freedom of the Seas. And we are trying now to accommodate them because they've been here for a significant number of time, a number of days offshore. And all the medical science tells us that they should be free of COVID because there were no reported incidents of COVID on board those vessels for the time that they were there. And the International Maritime Organization is, of course, asking countries to be kind and to be lenient in relation to how we treat seafarers who are now stuck, really, in foreign waters. But Barbados exhibited tremendous leadership, principle-driven leadership at a time when the world wasn't exhibiting leadership. And therefore, I wish to thank the staff and the management of the Bridgetown Port. I want to thank the chairman, who is now Minister of Tourism, also the Minister of Tourism, the Honorable Kerry Simmons. I want to thank the management and the staff of the port, as I said, but I really want to thank the guys who worked the ships, dockers, porters, the ones who were going out and bringing in the ships, handling the ropes, those guys, you know. The team at the Bridgetown Port has been amazing, putting themselves on the front line. We were able to clear all of those vessels and to clear them safely. Not a single incident of COVID reported as a result of our interactions there. The port was tremendously outstanding in the way it dealt with this issue. And I would like to commend the staff of the Bridgetown Port. And really and truly, this award is an honor to them for the work that they put in and a testimony to the kind of country that Barbados has always been and the kind of country that Barbados will always be. So on behalf of the Ministry of Maritime Affairs and Blue Economy and the Bridgetown Port, which falls under the Ministry of Maritime Affairs, we are very thankful for Seatrade for this award, for giving us the Cruise Destination of the Year for 2020.